know that I'm always hold you down, hold you down, hold you down. You know that I'm always be around, be around, be around. You know I feel worried about that thing, about that thing, about that thing. You know I feel worried about that thing. Through the highs and lows, you and me, baby girl, against the world, I'ma hold you down, down, down. Hold you down, down, down. Hold you down, down, down. Hold you.
Guess who's back?
Back again.
What?
Guess who's back? Guess who's back? We're back.
Okay, we're back, and this time we're not in the car.
Oh yes, we try to be a little bit lawny this time around. We went to the beach.
Let's show you. Let's show you.
Yay! Cool, right?
All right, back to us. Back to us.
Cool. Yeah.
Welcome, welcome. So today we're having a new topic of discussion. We know we've kept you waiting for a bit longer than we should have. But today we're discussing BRATING. So BRATING is an abbreviation
for
broke dating. Now, when we started dating back in the day, I was broke. I was like proper broke. No, I wasn't that broke. I didn't have money, but not like zero, zero. So anyway, but the cool thing is we still kind of hit it off. We're still able to hang out and stuff. And something that's actually quite monumental to us now is
licorice.
And so do you want to tell them why?
Yes. Okay. So this faithful packet here, I don't know if he was trying to kind of like do something about it. I don't know what he was trying to say. Maybe someone here could comment on what these signify, right?
Licorice is delicious. It doesn't signify anything. Just
sweet. It's not. It's like, okay, I know he had an issue with black, so all of them have a bit of black. You know, I had an issue with black, right?
You're looking too much into it.
No.
Just sweet.
Okay, anyway, he faithfully brought me these, and I'm convinced that he was trying to say something. I just don't know what it is. Maybe you're a sweet girl, or you know.
Those are just the sweets I could afford. Get to the point. Get
maybe
to the
you got
point.
No shape.
Get
you're
to
square.
The point.
I'm not sure what he was trying.
Get to the point.
Okay, and then we've got a Coke. I'll explain both of them. I think they actually don't really have a deep meaning. We just kind of made it work for us because it was the only thing he could afford, guys. Like, he could only afford these. And he faithfully brought them to me when I was in university. So there, you know, you're expecting, okay, let's go to, what are the places?
Oh, no,
here?
Fancy places.
Exactly.
Bay,
no, some, you know, show me, take me to Table Mountain, not a hike up Table Mountain.
It's down there.
Okay, yeah. Anyway, I'm saying, so because of those, somehow we made it work for us, right? It was a faithful, like when I just saw him with that pink packet and the black bottle, the black bottle of Coke, it just kind of made me feel all warm and fuzzy inside. I'm not saying be cheap. I'm not saying that the guys now shouldn't do that. Or the girls actually shouldn't take the guys out. But the only
girls take your guys out.
Yes, you should actually. It's not written anywhere that it's just a male thing. I mean, it's important to do that. They also need to feel loved, and they also need to be humbled, guys.
Yeah.
They need to be brought down to earth to say, hey, as a girl as well, I can do it. You, right?
That's going in a different direction.
No, it's not going.
We went on our first proper date, like after being together for like what, 2-3 years?
Yeah. Well, to the really fancy place.
Yeah, yeah.
Man, that place was fancy. But I'm not going to talk about it right now. If you want to know, you can.
That's another, especially to the ladies. This is from me as a guy. Don't look at a guy who doesn't have the GTI or.
Go beyond the Google Pack.
Whatever. Or someone who doesn't have like a house in Constantia already, or someone who doesn't take you to fancy places because you can't afford it. Don't look at those things and put someone completely out and say, look, that's not the guy I want. Because you need to realize that some people might have those things now, but character-wise, they're horrible people.
Yeah.
Or money is one of those things where you might have it now, you guys are dating, going to fancy places, and then you get married, you sign on the dotted line, and then God forbid something happens. And you lose the money. What happens?
And I've
then?
Got something for the guys.
Yeah.
You don't have to go all out to impress girls. I think sometimes there's a misconception that we want to be, you know, yeah, we
like
want to ride.
The more expensive something
exactly,
is, the better.
Exactly, but it's not the case. I think one of my most romantic things about this guy had nothing to do with money, actually.
Take notes.
It was undoing my hair. Very random. Undoing my hair. That's like dirty. I think somebody might think like, ew, oh my God, like how, but like, that was for me. I thought, oh my God, if this guy can sit and literally go through this greasy, dirty, knotted, ladies that have braids or something kind of know the drift.
Yeah.
But like, if you can go through something like that, I think that's highly romantic. Obviously, I mean, it's relative. People see things differently, but it's to say that don't necessarily assume that we want fancy stuff. Or we always want fancy stuff. Sometimes fancy stuff is good, but sometimes a walk in the beach is great.
Yeah, true. Take your girl on a break. Ladies, take your guy on a break.
Find something
interesting
it
to
may
do
not
that costs
be
you nothing. May not be coke.
It may not be
licorice.
But it may actually just be a walk.
Yeah, take a hike if you're that type of person. But maybe not a hike, because people are getting stabbed on hikes these days.
No, maybe not a hike.
Go to the beach like we've done right now. It doesn't have to cost you a bunch of money.
It doesn't have to cost you anything.
One massive, massive cliche is honesty is the best policy. Yeah. But it is a cliche for a reason. If you as a guy can be honest about your finances from the very beginning, and you as a lady can be honest about your expectations from the very beginning, you liberate each other and allow each other to kind of both be in the relationship.
Yeah, it's true.
If I have not been honest and I give you the perception that everything's okay financially, then your expectations are justified. And in the moment, all of a sudden, I don't have, then it is a problem.
Yeah.
And it's definitely a problem to deal with.
But ladies must be careful with their expectations, because a lot of them are distorted because they're not really...
Of Hollywood and stuff, yeah.
Yeah, not even Hollywood. It's the girl next door. Like, you open the door for me, or someone does that, and I'm expecting that, okay, Oliver is going to do that, but he's not really... that way wired. So make it work for you guys, and communication is always key from the beginning to till you're old and gray.
Yeah.
Talking is the most important thing, because when you talk, you kind of get the person's heart, and you make it work, and
so do us a huge favor, comment what you think about the video.
Yeah,
tell us what you want to hear about next. If it's like a secretive thing, you can send us direct messages. Also, any special ideas you've had or any braids you've been on that were really specifically awesome, put them down so that other people can copy, emulate. Or if you have any brilliant braiding ideas, feel free to put those in there. And also let us know if there's been any relationship that has started because of this video. You were shutting someone down.
But now you're like,
yo, listen, we can build each other up.
Yeah.
Or if you as a guy has been liberated.
Okay, dude, it's our braiding time now. Bye.
Bye. Okay, we have to break. Don't forget to like the page, share the page, like our video, comment, tweet us. Tell us what your special thing is. Ours is licorice and coke. And we'd love to hear your stories on braiding, dating, and all things love.
Yeah.
Bye. I dropped the phone.
You know that I'm always hold you down, hold you down, hold you down. You know that I'm always be around, be around, be around. You know I feel worried about that thing, about that thing, about that thing. You know I feel worried about that thing through the highs and lows.